Hello viewers, welcome to ANSYS-Tutor. In this video, I will demonstrate a simple fluid flow problem in a sinusoidal pipe. In the previous video, I had shown how to create the sinusoidal pipe geometry using SpaceClaim. In this video we would see how to mesh the sinusoidal pipe geometry, how to set up the ANSYS Fluent CFD solver, and finally we will get the solution output results in CFD post processing. Before we start the demonstration, I would request you, please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to activate the channel notifications. We had shown in the previous tutorial regarding how to create the sinusoidal pipe geometry. You can find the video link in the description. Let's start with the meshing of the pipe geometry. Right-click on Mesh and select Edit. This is the Meshing Workbench window. Right-click on the mesh in the project outline. Then select Insert, select the method. Select the geometry and click on Apply. In the definition, select the Hex Dominant method. Change the default element size to 0.001. Turn on the adaptive sizing option for a better cell distribution. Right-click on the mesh and then generate the mesh. The mesh is generated with maximum number of hex cells. Select the face of the sinusoidal geometry and denote it as the pipe inlet. Select the other face of the geometry and name it as the outlet. Select the pipe surface and name it as pipe wall. Right-click on Mesh and select Update. It will link the generated meshed cells with the CFD solver. Now you can close the mesh and proceed for CFD solver setup in Fluent. Select the double precision and click on Start. Double precision will use 64 bits per floating point number, which will decrease the round-off errors. After the solver gets loaded, add the fluid materials from the Fluent database. Select the water liquid and click on Copy. Then close the material database. In the models, select the K-Omega SST turbulence viscous model. Now, assign the material in the cells in. Now, put the boundary conditions. At the inlet boundary, put the inlet velocity of water is 1 meter per second. Keep the default turbulence specification method if you don't have the data of the turbulent intensity and turbulent viscosity ratio. Keep the default pressure outlet boundary condition at the outlet. Click on the solution method, then select the second order upwind spatial discretization for turbulent kinetic energy and specific dissipation rate for a better solution accuracy. Open the residual monitor and decrease the residuals up to 10⁻⁶. The solver will continue to iterate until all the numerical equations reach this residual value. Select the hybrid initialization. Click on Initialize. Hybrid initialization is complete. Now, proceed for calculation. Put the number of iteration and click on Calculate. Calculation is complete. Solution is not converged, but as per the iteration versus residual graph, there is not much variations, so we can stop the calculation process and proceed for result extraction. Open the results window, that is the CFD Post Processing workbench. Insert the streamlines to see the fluid propagation in the sinusoidal path. Insert the quick animation to see the flow animation along these streamlines. Turn off the streamline. Click on the location. Insert a new reference plane. Select the default reference plane and click on Apply. Insert a contour to observe the velocity variations in the plane. Select the location as plane 1. You can change the default legend view style. Click on the camera icon to save the image of the contour. Enter the desired image size and quality. Then click on Save. Similarly, generate the pressure variation contour. Insert the velocity vector to observe the variations along the reference plane. Let's conclude this demonstration. If you have any query, then please comment below. If you like this video, then hit the like button. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.